So what is missing, aside from those photographs, what is missing that you had stored?
My family's entire genealogy lineage. I can promise you that.
And have you given us a list, an itemized list of the valuation of these items?
Of some of it, yes, sir.
And how much does it amount to?
I'm not.
Just give me an estimate of right now.
$5,000. Okay. I mean, that's now, just the right jewelry.
Now, you said, in response to her letter of apology, you said, yes, we did, and your stuff is safe and will be safe. Mm-hmm. But it wasn't safe. Because you claim somehow it got wet.
It did get wet.
And it got mildewed, so it wasn't safe.
How did it get wet?
It's rain. It was in Oregon.
So it got wet 3 years earlier?
Yes.
Yes.
No, no, no.
Yes, it was.
No. His wife said that when she went there to take their son back, that she found my pictures and my clothes and all kinds of stuff outside on the trailer.
We can't hear that. She's not here.
No. So if it got rained on in Oregon, why take it with you all the way to Oklahoma?
I didn't take it. My brother, it was under his storage shed. He loaded all the totes up in his U-Haul with his own personal property to bring it to
Oklahoma. Brought some damaged items.
Yes, yes.
That you later discovered was damaged.
Yes.
And threw away.
Yeah.
When did you discard the property?
They have been in a storage unit.
When did you discard the property?
My uncle discarded it.
In June. In July.
What?
Everything out of storage. August, okay.
August of 23.
Yeah. Of 23?
Oh my God.
Yes.
Yes, and he moved it out, and his wife had texted her and
did you
said,
let her know that you were destroying it?
No, I didn't know anything
did
about
it. Did you let her know?
I didn't know it was destroyed until after it was gone.
I didn't know anything about that part.
Never got
Where's
a
uncle?
Test.
Where's uncle? Ma'am, when did you file your lawsuit?
In June of 23, and the reason is because the correspondence.
June of 23, when did they receive notice of the lawsuit? Do you know?
Never.
Right after that, because I sent a picture to Jeff of it being that it was filed.
Do you have that on your phone?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Did you get a picture of the lawsuit having been filed, which, by the way, does not constitute proper service of process?
No, I didn't.
Of course not.
I didn't know I was getting sued.
But it was on notice. All right, we'll see.
That's why we're just in a state of shock. Like, what?
It was actually July. I'm sorry that I sent you a picture.
Oh, that makes sense. Okay.
Right. That's to him. Please.
Just to let him know.
This is what I'm doing.
July 16th, 2023, she texted you photographs of the front page of the lawsuit. And you threw away her stuff after she texted you those photographs.
No.
We didn't throw her
You stuff. Said August!
I don't pay much attention to her texts.
Well, yeah, that's the problem.
That's
you know
true.
What I mean?
All right, that's all
that's
we needed
I try
to know.
I try to avoid her texts.
All right,
I'm good. They're usually
not. Yeah. Running
Thank
her mouth.
Thank you very much. We're going to excuse the parties while we deliberate in this matter. We will pay attention.
We have deliberated and reached a unanimous verdict. Mr. Fugate, your mother, on behalf of you, took responsibility for safeguarding the property. We have your property. We will keep it safe. Despite conflicting accounts of your communications, the only evidence we have before us completely supports your position, Ms. Nelson, that you consistently asked to try to get it back. You didn't cooperate in that process in even the slightest, and in fact told her you didn't have any of it. And so you're entitled to recover for that. However, Ms. Nelson, you are not able to prove the value of that stuff because it was destroyed after a lawsuit was commenced. Now, we did not agree on whether that was deliberate, that you knew about the lawsuit and then destroyed it, but you provided no notice to her. A lawsuit had already begun, and so the destroying of the evidence is what compromised your ability to prove its value. So for that reason, Ms. Nelson, we are awarding you the stuff that we have, as well as $5,000, because your inability to prove the value is not as a result of your own actions. Mr. Fugate, on your counterclaim, you requested fees for moving the property from Oregon to Oklahoma, which you did while you were in a relationship, without any promise to be repaid. You can't, when there's no promise or expectation of repayment, come later and say, I want to be reimbursed for something I did during a relationship. Similarly, there was no discussion anywhere that we saw about repayment for the storage fees. So for that reason, we're dismissing your countersuit in its entirety. So, Officer Montejano, we're going to ask that you retrieve the plaintiff's belongings and present them to her so that we're transferring the property here in court.
Thank you.
And so the verdict is in favor of the plaintiff for the return of your items, which you now have, as well as $5,000, and the countersuit is dismissed. Thank you both.